We've had a 20-year relationship with Seton Hall, with the School of Diplomacy and International Relations, and it's really helped us blossom and grow as a grassroots movement of Americans who believe in strong U.S. leadership at the UN. Now, it's evolved considerably since then. Right now, we really depend on the thought leadership of the school. We are connecting to young Americans who are eager to be engaged in the global arena, who believe that the mission and work of the UN is important to them, and we're able to give them great content, great access to the UN by working in partnership with Seton Hall's faculty and by doing joint programs together in New York and in Washington. I think there are a couple of key moments in our partnership that really reflect its success, but also its trajectory going into the future. One is the UN Intensive Program. The next would be the Washington Semester Program. And then the third, I would say, is the Seton Hall University campus chapter of the United Nations Association. There are opportunities to be directly engaged with the UN like never before. The school recognizes that. And I think it's an exciting time to join the Board of Overseers to help guide the next direction to the school, to build on its success in establishing itself as the preeminent school of international affairs focused on the UN. I would like to see two things. I would like to see the university continue its thought leadership in the UN space through its faculty, which has grown exponentially over the last 20 years. But I'd like to see even more direct student engagement with the UN. That because of the Sustainable Development Goals and other new changes in the UN system, the UN isn't something that you learn about and then prepare to do work with once you graduate. You can actually play a leadership role in the human rights discussion, in the discussion on accelerating ambition on climate change, on gender rights, on many other issues right now as a student.